Meanwhile, Mexico's new president-elect, Enrique Peña Nieto, will take office December 1st after getting 38% of the vote in the July elections. And now his supporters expect him to deliver on his campaign promises and to improve their lives. As Nitza Soledad Perez reports, he has a long list of things to fix to help the Mexican economy.
The new president-elect of Mexico, Enrique Peña Nieto, promises a 6% economic growth. He plans to achieve this goal by relaxing the labor market, bringing private investment to the oil industry, and increasing tax revenue. But is that feasible? Politics might hinder some of his ambitions.
Since Peña Nieto won by a smaller margin than the polls had indicated, and since the lower house of Congress and the Senate seem to be having a greater number of legislators from opponent parties, he's less likely to have an easy way of implementing some of the policies he promised during his campaign.
Mexico is riddled by monopolistic practices. This lack of competition becomes a stop sign for innovation. And Mexicans end up paying high price tags for basic services. This bookstore owner says his business is doing well, but not for the right reasons. Mr. Hernandez believes the first thing Peña Nieto should do to stimulate the economy is to deal with gas prices.
There is no effective plan. We buy expensive gas and sell cheap oil. There is no plan for the most productive company in Mexico, Pemex. Our economy is never going to improve.
And he's not alone. Taxi drivers are tired of the soaring prices.
Before, 250 pesos, around $20, would last for 2 days. Now a $30 Tunley drives me around for a day and a half. This is affecting me.
Winning the support of his people will also be a challenge for Peña Nieto.
Well, at the beginning, he will bring economic stability. Everything will be fine and dandy for now. But in 3 years from now, they will all start stealing our money as usual.
Peña Nieto has not even started, and his victory is being questioned by a powerful contender. A possible delay for his financial program.
In 2006, protesters blocked his entire main road for 6 months, alleging electoral fraud. Now, many Mexicans fear that a repeat of that might affect Mexico's image and economy. Nitza Soledad Perez, CCTV, Mexico City.